Number six. This one says, describe how you would prepare 2,500 milliliters of a 1:1,000 aluminum acetate solution in antiseptic from half gram aluminum acetate tablets. Now, first of all, describe how you would prepare. I'm looking again for a sentence, okay? So on your worksheet, when I leave the long blank for the answer, I want a sentence. Now I'm going to start, and I want to make 2,500 milliliters, so I'm going to start with this in my dimensional analysis, just like I was doing on my previous problems. The strength that I want to get is 1:1,000. So I want to have a strength of 1:1,000. Now I need to go back and put my units in there. And I can tell you that this was dry because you started with what? Not milliliters. Why would you know this is dry? What in the problem tells you it's dry?
Tablets.
Right there, grams, tablets. Okay, that's all dry. So that meant this was milliliters and this was grams. And then we have tablets. Each tablet is half a gram. So I could just finish off my dimensional analysis and be able to show you how much you would need. And so on your calculator, you can do 2,500 divide by 1,000 divide by 0.5. And you end up with 5 tablets. Okay? And so now my sentence would be to, for example, you could say dissolve 5 tablets in a small amount of solvent. Add more solvent. To the level of 2,500 milliliters, and make sure you mix. But that's basically what you need to do. So it's a lot like the previous problems, it's just I have a tablet tacked on the end because now they told me where the dry medicine was coming from, and it happened to come from a tablet. Now look through the list again to see if you see anything else that mentions tablets.
8.
Okay, 8's a good one. It says explain how to prepare a 1 liter of a 1% ammonium chloride solution from 1 gram ammonium chloride tablets. Okay? Now I need 1 liter. Alright, 1 liter is the same thing as 1,000 milliliters. So you can start with 1,000 milliliters and then continue the problem on just like we did in number 6. And I want a 1% solution. Now how do you write your fraction for
1%?
1 over 100, good. And what units would you have?
Grams
and then milliliters. Okay, now I can get an answer in grams, but I was told that it was 1 gram tablets. Now, if you didn't write this part down but could still see the answer, this would be fine. But you could just say 1 gram, 1 tablet. Now, is it going to affect the numerical answer? No, because that's really times 1. But you're going to essentially have 1,000 divided by 100. So you're going to end up with 10 tablets. But to change your answer, you would say dissolve 10 tablets, instead of 5 in the previous sentence, in a small amount of solvent, add more solvent to the level of 1,000 milliliters, or you could write 1 liter. That's kind of your choice. Doesn't really matter. But this will turn into 10 and this will turn into 1,000. Just make sure you put the unit with it. So if you say 1,000 milliliters, that's fine. If you said 1,000 liters, that would be bad. Okay, because it's completely different. Look through and see if you can find one more problem that's like this. Okay, 12. Describe how to prepare 4,000 milliliters of a 1 to 50 solution of the antiseptic potassium permanganate from a 1/2 gram potassium permanganate tablets. So I have another tablet situation. I want a total of how many milliliters?
4,000.
Okay, so I want 4,000 milliliters. How do you do the 1 to 50?
1 over 50.
Yeah, just 1 over 50. What are the units?
Grams.
Yeah, grams and milliliters. So 1 over 50. So, you know, even though it's not a percent, you still use it the same way. Now, we're looking at tablets. Oh, that works that well. 1/2 gram is 1 tablet. So you would do 4,000 divided by 50 divided by 0.5. Okay, 160 tablets. Now this is probably one of the rare times that you will get a very large number of tablets. I don't know about you, but I don't want to count out 160 tablets. I don't know what these tablets look like. Maybe we wouldn't make such a big solution. Maybe we'd make 1/4 of it or, you know, something like that, 1/10 of it, I'm not sure. But if we wanted to make 4,000 milliliters, we'd have to use 160 tablets. But normally, your answers are showing up as like 1 tablet, 2 tablets, 10 tablets maybe. You usually don't have very high numbers, but that's due to the fact of making 4 liters of this solution. And you know how big a 2-liter is, so 4 liters would be 2 2-liters, so you're making that volume. Okay? Any questions? Okay, the last little bit of problems, if you look at 11, when you read through number 11, it says, determine how many milliliters of a 1 to 10,000 epinephrine solution will contain 5/1000ths of a gram of epinephrine. Now, here are the things that you're given. 1 to 10,000, that's your strength. You also have 5/1000ths of a gram. Now I need to put units on this strength right here because this is going to help me figure out how to do my problem. This is a strength, so it's either grams over milliliters or milliliters over milliliters. What is it?
Grams over milliliters.
Grams over milliliters. Now, if you notice, we always start with one number and we usually multiply it by the strength, whether it's a ratio or a percent. Now watch what would happen if I'm not thinking and watching what I'm writing down. If I start with the grams, which is the only other number I have, and then I say multiply it by its strength, does that work?
No.
No, it breaks dimensional analysis laws. So what do you have to do with the strength?
Flip it.
You get to flip it. So this is the time, if you start with the drug, this is when you have to flip the percent or the strength as a ratio. It doesn't matter which one. But you have to flip it because the units won't cancel. So it makes no sense to leave it as is. So that's not going to work. What is going to work is if I say 1 gram on the bottom and 10,000 milliliters on top. And then I would have basically 5,000 times 10,000. And this is going to give me an answer in milliliters.
Milliliters.
Because the grams now cancel out. So if I have 50 milliliters with this strength, I know that this is how much drug is in here. Now, what's another question similar to this one? 16. And notice that if you look at 16, you'll see 20% and you'll see 60 grams. So right there, that makes it jump out at me. In 16, if I had 20%, that would be 20 over 100. Because of the grams, that would be grams over milliliters. But when I try to do my calculation, I'll start with the 60 grams, but the only way it's going to cancel with that strength is if I take that percent and reverse it or flip it. That's the only way that this would work. Your grams will cancel out. How many milliliters would you be left with?
300.
60 times 100 divided by 20? 300 milliliters. Okay, and then there's one more problem that we haven't done that's like this. Which one's left?
19.
Okay, 19 is how many milliliters of a 2% solution contain 50 milligrams of pure drug? Is there anything in there that bothers you?
Milligrams.
Milligrams, okay. Because when I work out the strength for 19, and I have a 2% solution, 2% is 2 over 100, it's dry, which means grams over milliliters, but I'm going to start with 500 milligrams. This is how much I'm looking at. Now, I would want to flip my strength, but it's not ready yet because it's in grams, and right now I'm in milligrams. Can I get myself to what the strength is in? Can I go from milligrams to grams? Definitely. 1,000 milligrams, same thing as 1 gram. And now you can take the strength and you can flip it, and you can do your calculation. And then 19, I believe, is what, 25 milliliters? So the milligrams and the grams are gone, you're left with milliliters. 25 milliliters would be your final answer. And so if you had 25 milliliters of that strength, you'd be guaranteed to have 500 milligrams of the pure drug. But essentially, you have about 5 different types of problems. Diluting a stock solution, so you'll see 2%. Writing the strength in general, grams over milliliters, or milliliters over milliliters. Working with the solution, figuring out how much drug is in it. Usually grams is a typical answer. Making that solution, you'll see tablets mentioned. And then the last thing is if you are looking at how much drug you have with your strength, you have to flip that strength so that you can get dimensional analysis to work. You'll see how much solution you would have.